गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज अरुल मुरुगन. वेलकम टू माय डिजिटल क्लास. चैप्टर नेम डेटाबेस कॉन्सेप्ट्स, लेक्चर वीडियो पार्ट 7. इन अ टुडेज क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस फिजिकल डेटा इंडिपेंडेंस. वी ऑलरेडी नो दैट व्हाट इज डेटा इंडिपेंडेंस, विच मीन्स द एबिलिटी टू चेंज द स्कीमा डेफिनेशन एट वन लेवल विदाउट अफेक्टिंग द नेक्स्ट हायर लेवल. देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ data independence. First one, physical data independence. Second one, logical data independence. In a today's class we are going to discuss physical data independence. In a physical data independence, the first point, data is stored in a bit format. So we know that everyone, what are the data we are storing in the system, the data will be stored in the form of bits. We know that what is bit, 0 and ones. The storage mediums are like hard disk, floppy disk, drum, tapes, SD cards. So these are all the different types of storage mediums are available. Majorly we are using hard disk only. System designs depending on the type of application and the need of users. So based on these two parameter we are designing the system. So whenever we are going to develop the system design, it is purely based on these two parameter, which are types of application and need of users. So in a physical data independence, these are all the three points. The first one is data is stored in the form of bit. Second one, the storage mediums like a hard disk, a floppy disk, like this, majorly we are using hard disk only. System designs depending on the type of application and need of users. In a physical data independence, these are all the file organizations are available. First one, serial file organization. Second one, sequential file organization. Third one, random or direct access file organization. Fourth one, self or direct addressing. Fifth one, random access method. And sixth one, indexed sequential access method. So these are all the types of file organizations are available. You may ask one question, what is file organization? It is too simple. How you are storing a file and how you are organizing, how, you know, which method you are using to organize those files. Understand, we already know that what is a file. It is the smallest storage unit in the system. First, serial file organization. In a keyword we can understand serial file organization. What is serial? Which means one after another. That's all. That records are stored one after another. Too simple. So what is serial file organization? Records are stored one after another. But here what is the important? We are not following any particular order. That's all. Chronological order, which records are added to the file. What is chronological order? We can take one small example in a bank transaction. Assume that 9 o'clock one transaction is happened. So we will store the transaction first. Next, 9:30 another transaction is happened. So what we have to do, we have to store the next transaction in the database. Understand? So like this chronological order. So what is serial file organization? The records are arranged one after another. We are not following any particular order, in a chronological order only. So example, in a bank transaction. Advantages: we can access the data very fast to next record. Economical storage medium, easy to do backup. So these are all the advantages. Next, sequential file organization. What is sequence? Sequence also one after another, but here we are following some particular order. See, the data are stored one after another in ascending or descending order. Understand, either we have to store the record ascending or descending order. Here we are using some key field like alphabetical order, A, B, C, D, like this. Computer must read a file sequence from the beginning to access the data. Assume that I am going to search one record which is stored in D, which record name, understand. So the record name is starting D, or we can take an example, data. So data is a record name. So how you have to access the record, in the sense you have to start from A. First you have to search in a ए अल्फाबेट, नेक्स्ट वी हैव टू सर्च इन बी अल्फाबेट, नेक्स्ट वी हैव टू सर्च इन डी अल्फाबेट, नेक्स्ट ओनली वी हैव टू सर्च इन डी. सो वेन एवर यू आर गोइंग टू एक्सेस द डेटा इट हैज टू सर्च फ्रॉम द बिगिनिंग. अंडरस्टैंड? सो वॉट इज सीक्वेंशियल फाइल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इन द सेंस द डेटा आर स्टोर्ड वन आफ्टर अनदर इन अ पर्टिकुलर ऑर्डर ईदर असेंडिंग आर डिसेंडिंग ऑर्डर. सो वी आर डिटरमाइंड बाई की फील्ड. सो द कंप्यूटर मस्ट रीड फाइल इन अ सीक्वेंस फ्रॉम द बिगिनिंग टू एक्सेस द रिकॉर्ड. अंडरस्टैंड? नेक्स्ट रैंडम और डायरेक्ट एक्सेस फाइल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. सो यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड वॉट इज डायरेक्ट एक्सेस फाइल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इन द सेंस. Direct access in a file organization allow immediate direct access to individual record. You should understand what is a record and what is file. A file is a basic storage unit in a system. A record in the sense it is a individual record. So collection of record we can consider as a file. So inside the file there are number of records are available. So assume in your mind a file, the file containing number of records. Understand? The record are stored and retrieved using relative record number. Assume that in a particular file there are n number of records are storing. While storing you are giving some relevant record number. The record number used to give the position of the record, so where you are storing. So by using the record number we can able to access the record directly. Understand? Assume file, the file containing number of records, each record having record number, the record number which gives the position of the record. So with the help of record number I can able to access the record directly. Understand? This type of organization also allows file to access sequentially. Here also we have to access the file sequentially, which means one after another, like whenever we are going to search file record which is starting from D, we have to search sequentially. After getting the record I can get the record number, so the record number will tells the where the record is stored. Understand? The primary storage CPU truly provides the direct access, so the CPU only will give the record number. So based on this record number only we can store the data and we can retrieve it directly. So the direct access storage device having capability of directly reaching any location. So there are n number of direct access storage mediums are available, but generally a CPU will give the direct access number. So with the help of this CPU we can able to generate record number and we can store. Too simple. Direct access mean file is containing number of records, each record having relevant relative record number, the record number which gives the position of the record. Understand? So with the help of the record number only we can able to access the record. So who will give the record number means CPU. So with the help of this record number we are storing and we are retrieving. Understand? Next, self or direct addressing. See, under the self or direct addressing a record key is used to act as a relative address. So therefore anyone can compute the record's address from the record key and the physical address of the first record in a file. So it is a very simple to understand. Assume that there are 3 rooms or there are 10 rooms are available. So I am telling each room you are going to send only allocate 5 students. So each room you are going to allocate only 5 students. So I am storing in a sequence order. First 5 students, they have to allocate first room. Next 5 students, they have to allocate second room. Next 5 students, they have to allocate third room. Understand the concept? So assume that there are number of students are available. First 5 students, first student, second, third, fourth, fifth. First 5 students, where they will allocate? First room. 6 students where you have to allocate second room. Understand? So in a second room next 5 students, 6 7 8 9 10. 11th student where we have to allocate third room. Understand? So we can easily calculate the first record in a system because each storage place will be allocated same first room. Assume that first room only 5 students, second room only 5 students, third room only 5 students. So by using this method, we can able to access directly by using record key. Understand? Too simple. I'm going to explain one more time. Under self direct addressing, a record key is used as its relevant relative address. So assume that 11th student, where he will store, where you will allocate in a third room. Understand? That's all. Therefore, anyone can compute the record's address from the record key and the physical address of the first record in the file. Understand or not? Fourth student, where he will be there? He will be allocated in the first room. 12th student, where you have to allocate? You have to allocate in the third room because the storage space is fixed. Understand? Advantages: self-addressing, no need to store any index. So here we no need to store any index like which student where is stored. It is very easy to store in our mind only. And here disadvantages: records are must be fixed length. Understand? So this is the major disadvantage in this file organization. So the records must be a fixed length. In case if you delete a record, the space will be remains. Assume that in a first room you are removing 2 students. That's all. Again, you cannot able to add 2 more students. Once you removed, that's all. The 3 students will be remain exist only. So the space will be waste. So too simple. Direct addressing means under the self direct addressing, record key is used as a relative address. So by using this relative address, we can able to access it. With an example, in a first room 5 students, second room next 5 students. So based on this, anyone can able to access the record address, and easily they can predict the physical address of a first record. Understand? Next, random access method. So this is too simple. The files are stored on a disk by using hash algorithm. There is an algorithm called hashing algorithm. This hash algorithm only will take care all the operations like generating a physical address and where it has to store, how we have to retrieve. So all the operation will be take care by the hashing algorithm. So the technique provide converting the records key numbers to a physical location. So by using this hashing algorithm, whenever you are giving a record to the hashing algorithm, it will generate a record number. So the record number will used to store in the physical location. Too simple. There is algorithm we are using, hashing algorithm. With the help of hashing algorithm, we are storing the data and we are retrieving the data. How we are storing? If you are giving a record to the hashing algorithm, it will convert it into record key number. So the record key number used to store where the record has to be stored. Advantages: access the record quickly and direct, and transaction need not to be stored in a place sequence. So here another advantage, the records are no need to store sequentially. Where it has to be stored, it will determined by the hashing algorithm only. Disadvantages: address generation overhead. By using hashing algorithm, it will generate n number of addressing, so that will be a difficult task. Next, less efficiency of storage space. So by using this hash algorithm, we are storing all the records. The record will be stored here and there, so we cannot use the storage space more efficiently. Too simple. Random access method means hash algorithm. Understand? By using hash algorithm, we are storing the data and we are retrieving the data. How? If you are giving a record, it will be converted into record key number. So the record key number, based on that, we will store. Understand? Next, indexed sequential access. So this indexed sequential access method, it is a hybrid between sequential and direct access. So it is a hybrid between both sequential and direct access. The record within a file are stored sequentially, but records are accessed possible to individually through the indexed. Here, index permit access to select record without searching. To understand this method, we can take one small example. Table content. Assume that in a first chapter there are number of topics are available. Understand? So that assume the chapters are arranged in a particular order: chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, chapter 4. So the chapters will be accessed sequentially. In the chapter, if you want to access some particular topic, if you take database concepts, in a database concept we are studying, number of topics are available. So in a particular topic, for example, data independence. So if we see the data independence, we can come to know what is the page number. So by using this page number, we can access the data directly. We can access the topic directly. That is the concept. So here, the records within a file are stored sequentially. So we are storing all the record sequentially. But here, the record can be accessed directly by using index. You should know what is index means. The index having a record name with where it is stored. Understand? Advantages: it permits efficient and economical, permit direct access. So we can able to access the record directly. Disadvantages: file must be stored in a direct so that expensive of hardware and software resources are required. So if you are using ISAM method, we need expensive hardware and software. To access a record may be slower than direct. So in this method, whenever we are going to access the record, it will be very slow searching method. So what is indexed sequential access method? In the sense, it is hybrid between sequential and direct access. You should understand records within a file. So the file containing number of records. Records within a file stored sequentially, but we can able to access the record directly by using index. We should know what is index means. The index having keyword, which means record name with physical address. So if you are using the index, we can able to access the record directly. So these are all the types of file organizations are available. The first one, serial file organization. Second, sequential file organization. Third, random or a direct file organization. Fourth one, self direct addressing. Fifth one, random access method. And finally, indexed sequential access method. So again, watch the video one more time if you have any doubt. It is a very easy topic only, easy concepts. You just to see the video one more time. Still, if you have any doubt, you can call me or you can message me. Thank you for watching this video. We will meet next class with some other topic. Thank you.